16 at the half, and they secure the number 3 seed by beating William and Mary. And it was the cousins from Columbus, Ohio, A.J. Davis and Devon Moore, that got the job done.
They kept it all in the family, I tell you, Al. But A.J. Davis, lately, he's been on an absolute tear. He poured in 36 points in that game, and he was in the doghouse early in the year. Wasn't logging a lot of minutes. The explosiveness was always there until he came along mentally. Matt Brady kept him on the bench, but as of late, he's been doing an awesome, awesome job. And Devon Moore, what more can you say about this young man? He's been through a lot throughout his career. He's been ups and downs. He's had some injuries. He's the heart and soul of this ball club. He makes that engine go. And what's interesting about him, he makes key plays at the right time, Al. He doesn't have gaudy numbers, as you see there, 11 points and 4 assists. But when a big play needs to be made, he's the one with the ball in his hands.
And the weird part about it, William and Mary shot lights out from the field and from behind the arc, something they do so very well. And they had a tremendous early performance by one of the most explosive guards in the league in Marcus Thornton.
Marcus Thornton is big time. His style of play reminds me an awful lot of Steve Francis, from former player from Maryland. He's a super athletic guard that can get points in bunches.
Well, you see what William and Mary can do from the field, and they have been red hot as of late from behind the arc. And as you mentioned, Ron, leading the way is that guy Thornton, who can score from anywhere in the field, but is really especially deadly for a three-point range.
He has a really quick release, and when he comes down in transition, you have to find him. He can go off the bounce, he can catch and shoot. And if you push up on him too much, he has the explosiveness to get all the way to the basket and finish with a dunk. The big improvement for him from last year to this year is his shot selection.
Well, he is going to be a guy closely watched and heavily depended on by the folks at William & Mary. Let's introduce our starting lineups, and let's begin with the third-seeded Dukes of James Madison University. It is a senior-laden team, but they've got some dynamite freshmen to work as well. You see A.J. Davis, Elion Diouf, both are seniors, along with Rayshon Goins and Devon Moore, also seniors. The lone non-senior is freshman Andre Nation. And they all play for Matt Brady in his fifth season at JMU. Matt is assisted by Rob O'Driscoll, Mike Dean, and Bill Phillips. And for William and Mary, their starting lineup will feature some interesting talent that Matt Brady and company will have to keep an eye on. We told you about Marcus Thornton. How about Matt Rum tonight? 127 games at William & Mary. He is the all-time games leader because of that. Brandon Ritz, explosive in the backcourt. And the CA's leading field goal percentage leader is Tim Rustoven. He'll also work with Kyle Gaylard for Tony Shaver. Tony is in his 10th season at William & Mary. Jonathan Ohms, Cody Kimball, and Austin Shaver are Tony's assistants. So Ron, as you take a look at this game, have you got a couple keys to concentrate on this evening?
Yeah, I do. When you think about JMU, they have to make sure that they don't fall in love with the quick jump shot. They're going to be open perimeter shots, make a few passes. A.J. Davis tends to come down and take the first look. That shot's going to be there. And then secondly, for William and Mary, Rustoven. Tim Rustoven cannot get in foul trouble. He's made a world of difference for this ball club. He was injured last year. William and Mary struggled mightily. He comes back this year. He's healthy. He's one of those post guys that can step out and face up and hit the face-up jump shot. But he's the heart and soul. He's the glue of this ball club.
Ron, as we told you, these two teams have met twice previously. The last time, just last Saturday, in the last game each side has played. How much of that, if any, carries over to tonight?
Well, I think you have to forget that game. But what it does, though, it lets both ball clubs know that we have to start off sharp. We can't take anything for granted. And let's be frank, Al. It's postseason play.
Yeah.
If you lose or you go home right now.
Well, this is the 87th time the 85th time these two teams have met. And they've met a lot recently in tournament play. Sean Cassidy, Bill Cummington Jr., and Tim Ebersole are officials. And we're underway with the third and final quarterfinal game of the CAA tournament in Richmond, Virginia. It's William and Mary with first possession, wearing their green trimmed in gold, JMU in white with the purple trim. As you see, Rayshon Goins, a good sign, committing or forcing a turnover against William and Mary. And this is the 10th time they have met in the CAA tournament, these two teams. Great rivalry on display this evening.
Al, of all the players on the floor, Goings, Rashawn Goings for JMU, number 33 in white, he wants to get himself going. He was one of their main go-to guys early on this season, but he's just had a miserable February and early March.
Well, there he has one shot missed, another shot blocked, and a shot clock violation on JMU's first possession. Take another look at this.
Look at Rashawn Goings. The first shot fell a little short. Give him credit for staying after, but he's going to have to find a way to come up with something when he gets the ball that close, either a foul or the bucket.
But at least you like to see him active like that early
exactly.
on, being
exactly.
aggressive.
It was an interesting story with him. He lost 45 pounds coming into this season. Well, I'm looking at him now. He seems to be a little bit heavier than he was earlier in the season, and that could be a problem or would be a reason why he struggled as of late.
Only 2 points last Saturday against William & Mary. Sat almost the entire second half, and in his last three games has scored 6, 6, and 2 after nearly double figures. And there is a man who you have to keep an eye on. We told you he leads the CAA and one of the top in the nation at field goal percentage.
I told you, Rustoven is the heart and soul of this ball club. He has to stay on the floor, can't afford to get in foul trouble. Always seems out to be in the right place at the right time, but he's highly, highly skilled. As this game progresses, you'll see his passing ability as well.
Ron, we should tell our audience, you're going to see a lot of that tonight. He's so good and fundamentally strong with the footwork in the pivot.
And that's the key. If your footwork is solid, whether you're a post guy or a guard, that sets you up for your entire game, whether it's going off the bounce or catching and shooting.
It's interesting to see A.J. Davis in the starting lineup. As he's gotten hot in the month of February and early March, he's been coming off the bench a lot. But after a career-high 36 points last Saturday, Matt Davis going with a hot hand. Andre Nation up.
I tell you what, hot may be an understatement for the role that A.J. Davis has been on as of late.
And William & Mary turns it over. Marcus Thornton throwing it away. A.J. Davis seems to pick on William & Mary. How about this for this year in the two games they played? Averaging 31.5 points. And he's shooting over 61% from the field, 60% from three-point range. And we're going to hear more about A.J. Davis's performance from Brent Harris in a moment.
I like early on how JMU Al's been patient. You know, that coming into the game, that was something I was curious about, whether they'd settle for quick early jump shots. They're moving the ball around, trying to get multiple touches before they look for a shot.
Their leader, Devon Moore, on the attack and gets the first points for the Dukes. You mentioned what a trying year it has been for Devon Moore, his mother battling brain cancer. He's had to drive out to Columbus, Ohio a number of times. But this young man is just a diligent player and great character that Matt Brady has learned to really lean on. Well, we talked about how hot A.J. Davis has been. Brent Harris, how about the February and early March of number zero?
That's been amazing. A.J. Davis, a senior transfer for Wyoming, is a young man who has had to do some maturing. So does head coach Matt Brady. He said he has had to buy into the team ideals. He wants to be part of something bigger than himself. And it took a little while for A.J. to realize that. So far, though, since he has realized that, he's been playing better defense and rebounding the ball. And Al, as you mentioned, he's playing some pretty good basketball, averaging 20 points over the last 7 games. And he had 63 points this year in the 2 wins over William & Mary.
Brent, thanks very much. The offensive goaltending call we see in Ron Thompson. Let's be honest, this is not a guy who's just come out of nowhere. This was a highly thought of player last year and coming into this season.
Well, he was a preseason second team all. I mean, last year he was second team all CAA. Coming into the season, he was picked first team preseason all CAA. So whether he could play or not wasn't the issue. He had to do an awful lot of maturing this season. I went to a few practices. He seemed listless. His focus wasn't there. It's good to see him regrouping and coming on at the end of the season.
He misses his first attempt down at the other end of the floor. Rashawn Goings has had some good looks inside. Hasn't been able to connect. Andre Nation leans in for a long three off the mark. Thornton trying to work baseline and kick a pass over to Britt. Had it knocked out of bounds by Devon Moore. We see Fred Heldring, a first substitution of the night. He'll come in off the William & Mary bench as Tim Rusthoven will get a blow.
Traditionally, William & Mary likes to be patient in their hybrid Georgetown-style offense, but because of Britt and because of Thornton's ability to go one-on-one, Coach Tony Shavers allowed these guys to shoot a little quicker than usual.
They really move the ball around exceptionally well. Matt Rum had a good look. How about Heldring working the glass? And Britt buries a three.
You have to get to Britt as well as Thornton around that three-point arc. They're very, very solid shooters, and they both have really quick releases.
36% from behind the arc is Brandon Britt. And Rashawn Goins has had a couple good looks. Finally, Elion Diouf cleans it up.
See, that's the shot early in the year that Rashawn Goins was finishing. Right now, he's really having difficulty making that shot when someone's in between he and the basket.
Devon Moore is matched up on Brandon Britt. Keeps Andre Nation on Marcus Thornton. Britt will drive. Tosses it inside, and there's going to be a foul called. Fred Heldring will be shooting free throws when we continue. William & Mary has averaged 10 three-pointers made the last eight games. Brandon Britt has struck from there to start it. Tonight's CAA basketball coverage on Comcast Sportsnet is brought to you by GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance. And by Jenny King, the king of clean. The early lead belongs to William & Mary, 6-4. But on that JMU sideline, a very good coach in Matt Brady. And for more on Matt, here is Brent Harris.
Well, as you know, James Madison swept the Tribe this year in their two meetings. But head coach Matt Brady said something rather interesting this week. He said, I don't think we're the better basketball team. He said these two teams are very even. And he said that sweep this year can work against us. He worries that his team is a very young team. And now they play four freshmen more than any other team in the CAA. Maybe it's a little bit of coach speak. Maybe he was just trying to motivate his guys this week.
Interesting, Brent. Ron, you and I are familiar with a Hall of Famer named John Thompson, who used to use an expression, fattening frogs for snakes. Was that what Matt was doing there?
That's exactly right, because the guys that play a lion's share of his minutes are all upperclassmen, and the main go-to guys on this ball club are upperclassmen as well. But you have to kind of get yourself motivated. You have to make sure your team knows that you have to play each minute of every game.
No team in the NCAA has more seniors than Matt Brady's side. He's got six seniors, five of them redshirt seniors. However, one key one, as we see Elion Diouf stepping on the end line, one key redshirt senior, and a man who they hope to have back for a six-year if the NCAA will allow it, is Andrei Semenov, one of the most deadly three-point shooters in the country. Taylor Bessick, number 22 in white, has come into the contest, giving Goins a rest. We see another freshman, Ron Curry, number 2, also getting some action off Matt Brady's bench. Here's 2 to shoot. And Matt Rum had to just throw up a prayer. That's a shot clock violation, and Matt Brady will like that defense.
He certainly will, and the good thing is they didn't pick up a foul at the end of that shot clock.
That's the 3rd turnover on Tony Shaver's squad in the early moments. We see Rustoven checking back in. Freshman Terry Tarpey, number 25 in green, will come in. Rum and Heldring get a seat. Davis tries to put it on the floor, almost lost it, and did. That one he just buried his head and drove. Here's Thornton trying to get around the senior Devon Moore. Quick double team on Rustoven. The kick out, Tarpey off the mark. Curry attacks baseline, finds Taylor Bessick. Unfriendly roll there. We've seen James Madison get some good interior looks, Ron.
They've got some really good looks. They just have to find a way to finish these out.
And a late whistle is going to get Tim Rustoven to the line.
But I tell you what, the good thing for JMU, the shots that they're getting any shot that they want. It's not like William and Mary has stopped them from getting the type of shots they want. They just have to settle down, especially when they get the ball in the interior and finish those jump hooks.
That foul is on the freshman, Taylor Bessick, the young man out of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. We mentioned how Matt Brady has so many seniors, but it's an interesting dynamic when you look at this JMU group. They're either seniors or freshmen. There's really almost nothing in between, and the JMU freshmen total 32% of the points and 41% of the minutes, despite having now 5 seniors available to Matt Brady.
And that is going to bode well next season. The freshmen don't see it now, but the minutes that they've logged and the experience that they've gotten from the minutes they've played this year is going to be huge come next season.
The Rustoven rattles home a couple. The lead is 5 for William and Mary. Devon Moore, a long 3. Got that one.
I love his size at that point guard position. Al, you know, he's about 6'4", 6'5", long arms, can cover ground, just a solid, solid all-around ball player.
And there's a whistle flagged by Sean Cassidy as William and Mary will not back off.
This year's William and Mary Ball Club, they play at a lot faster pace than usual. When there's missed baskets and there's fast break opportunities, those guys are going to take it, especially when Britt or Thornton has the ball in their hands.
Britt with the first of his 2 free throws. Taylor Bessick, the freshman we mentioned a moment ago now, has gotten 2 quick personal fouls, but Matt Brady will keep him in the game. We see 3 freshmen in there as Charles Cook, number 4 in white, has joined Ron Curry and Bessick. So Brandon Britt with 5 early points. He's nearing a very interesting milestone at William & Mary. Cook watched by the freshman Tarpey. Davis closed off by Boatner. Moore backs it out with under 10 to shoot. And got Matt Rum to reach in. So Matt Rum picks up his first on the team.
Take a look at Devon Moore, not selling for the jump shot, pressing the issue, trying to get to the basket, and draws the foul. Great job at not just carelessly dribbling in there, but coming up with something.
Everything gets funneled through Devon Moore. He's very patient with the basketball, always looking for the best option. Charles Cook kicks it back out to Moore, and again there's under 10. So Moore will take it himself and finishes.
Great one-on-one play that time by Moore. The clock was winding down, and it seemed like JMU had nowhere to go, and he just put his head down and created something where there was nothing.
That's why he is the ultimate closer on this team. You see the things he can do. Great defense there by Cook. It forces the turnover. And Davis on the attack. Finishes with the left hand. His first bucket of the night. Ties the game at 11.
Now, Davis can flat out score the basketball, whether it be jump shots, whether it be getting to the basket. I saw him scrimmage earlier this year, JMU scrimmage Georgetown, and he just looked unreal in that scrimmage.
Inside, Rustovanas position on Davis, but traveled before the shot. There's a timeout on the floor. Tim Rustoven and William & Mary had the lead, but A.J. Davis and his cousin Devon Moore have brought the Dukes back. Moore with the spin in the paint. This game is tied at 11. Part of a great contingent in purple that has traveled from Harrisonburg, Virginia, across Highway 64 to get to Richmond, Virginia. And they've seen James Madison come back after starting 2 of 10 from the field. Ron Thompson, they've made the last three in a row and right into the hands of Devon Moore.
Well, Devon Moore that time, you know, 6'4 guard just getting in the paint, going up over his defender. That time, the defender goes under the screen. He makes him pay by nailing the three. And then here, this clock's winding down. Nothing was there. He found a way to get to the basket and convert. He set the tone and tempo early on for JMU in this first half.
He is 3 of 3 from the field. One of those, a three-pointer. He's got 7 points to lead all scorers. Davis, he'll fire a three and hits. So A.J. Davis has now got 5 points as he's come alive. Matt Rum continues the miseries for William & Mary from beyond the arc. They're just 1 of 7 from that range.
And credit JMU for doing an excellent job out at contesting all of these perimeter shots by William & Mary. They're not getting a lot of wide open looks.
Well, Matt Brady will tell you the things that have turned this season around for him, not just the points they've been able to put up, but it's that zero, it's the defense. Rustoven inside, couldn't get it to go. Goins back in the contest, challenged that. Britt on the move, and Brandon Britt has come up now with 7 points tonight.
That was an excellent change of pace that time by Britt. He thought he was going to settle for the jump shot, and then he saw the hole open up. He just shifted gears and got all the way to the rack.
we're going to get a foul inside as Brandon Britt has exploited a little inside crack in the armor.
Take a look. He was going to take the jump shot, but he saw everything spread open, and he just stepped on the gas and got all the way to the rack. This end of the court is where JMU has had a huge improvement out. They've become a lot more patient in their half-court sets. Early in the year, they would just settle for a quick jump shot, and the wrong guys would take shots. We see here now in early March them being a lot more efficient on the offensive end.
Well, you can be really efficient when you know how to shoot the basketball like A.J. Davis can. He has been lights out. He is now 30 of 62 from three-point range his last seven games. The lead is four for the Dukes. Rum, good fake and attacking. Rusthoven will clean it up. That's why you can shoot 55% from the field. Actually, Tim Rusthoven is closer to 56% to lead this conference, number 29 in the country in that department. Cook funnels it inside. Goins stumbling. Still seems a little frustrated right now. Davis got Thornton up in the air. Couldn't get the shot to go, but will be shooting free throws.
What makes Davis such a valuable scorer from the wing is not just his ability to shoot the ball, but he's 6'6". He's got good size. So, you know, he's got a strong body. So when he catches the ball on the wing, he always sees a clear angle to the basket because most of the guys that are guarding him are 2 or 3 inches shorter than him. And then you look at his frame, he can get to the rack and finish.
A little strong on that first one. Davis sitting on 8 points, 2 of 3 from three-point range. For the season, A.J. Davis, a 68% free throw shooter. So a look at that JMU bench where Devon Moore gets a breather. And short on this one. So A.J. Davis, it's amazing when you see a guy so deadly from three-point range and yet 68% from the stripe where no one's in his face.
And you know what? Sometimes it becomes mental at that point.
There's the Marcus Thornton we've been expecting. The explosive scorer buries his first three of the night. And just like that, William and Mary back on top. So the story from behind the arc, both of these two teams love to do damage there as Goins still unable to get anything to fall. He's now 0 of 5 from the field. So a timeout on the floor, freshman Charles Cook and JMU have watched A.J. Davis strike, but it's William and Mary in the lead by one. NCAA tournament quarterfinal action, the last game of the day, and it's been a good one so far, as William and Mary has carved out a one-point lead over A.J. Davis and James Madison and Ron Thompson. We've seen A.J. Davis strike inside and out.
Well, his confidence is extremely high right now. You see him in here in transition right now. In that situation, he was just bigger, stronger, and better than Matt Run. And then here on the wing, he catches it, his 6'6 size, just shoots over the defender. And then here, again, the late closeout, his feet are set. It's like target practice at this point.
8 points, 2 rebounds for A.J. Davis, who will now get a breather. So in the game right now, we do not see A.J. Davis or Devon Moore for James Madison. Diouf watching Thornton. Good defense there. Now Thornton working against the freshman Cook. He'll fire another three and gets hit by Andre Nation and will be shooting 3 free throws.
It's really hard to judge when Thornton is going to pull up and take that jump shot because he's got a herky-jerky motion to his game. His body language, his mannerisms really remind me of the former Maryland guard Steve Francis. Right there you see he pulls up, catches him right there on the wrist. Excellent call by the official.
That's high praise indeed. Marcus Thornton, a sophomore from Upper Marlboro, Maryland, so he kind of shares a little geography with Stevie Francis.
Let me tell you, to be mentioned in the same sentence with Steve Francis as a basketball player is a good thing. Stevie Francis could flat out get it.
Well, an all-CAA performer this year, first teamer, as after being an all-CAA rookie team member last year. And when you score as much as Marcus Thornton does, you take advantage of these opportunities at the line, an 82% free throw shooter. Buries all three, stretches the lead to 3. Chase out on Andre Nation, forces a travel.
Andre got a little bit too excited that time. He saw the opening and he shuffled the puppies just a little bit too much that time.
Matt Prater doesn't wait too long to bring back Devon Moore and A.J. Davis as Rayshon Goins, scoreless so far in this game, will sit along with freshman Ron Curry.
When you look at JMU's roster, Al, they don't have a lot of tall guys vertically, but they have a lot of guys in that 6'5", 6'6 range. So what that does is defensively, it allows you to do a lot of different things. Like here, you can full court, you can run and jump. Half court, you can switch and not be penalized.
Kyle Gaylord, a spinning move, had it stripped away. Rip! And that is now 1,001 points in the career at William & Mary for guard Brandon Britt, and he is only a junior. Andre Nation, it won't go. William and Mary has had a tough time with that rim inside the paint. Marcus Thornton forces Matt Brady into a timeout as Thornton and Britt have gotten it going from behind the arc. A 13-0 run for a 25-17 lead.
When you've got two guards like Thornton and Britt that have speed, that have energy, that have explosiveness, you have to pay attention in your half-court defense because these two guys can create their own shot and they can string together 3 and 4 shots consecutively and they can do it from behind the arc. Right here, nice between the through the legs pull-up from Thornton and he's feeling it. That time, JMU had no shot. Nation put his hand up when Thornton was on his way down from the shot. Thornton's release is far too quick. You gotta jam him, be there on the catch, because he's in a rhythm and a flow right now. Your best bet may be not to even let him catch the ball.
And Ron, when we see a guy like Marcus Thornton play, his release, he's so high on the jump that his release point is so quick. That combination of the quick first step, the high jump, and that quick release, that's virtually unstoppable.
And what has happened this season is Coach Tony Shaver said that he's been really pleased with his shot selection. See, when you have a guard that can get his shot whenever he wants, the best thing about him sometimes is that he can get a shot whenever he wants as Moore gets all the way to the basket. But the worst thing about a guard that can get a shot whenever he wants. He's a guard that can get a shot whenever he wants. So he's found the balance this season, which is hard for a scorer.
Well, just to remind everybody, last week when these two teams played, Marcus Thornton had 19 first half points. He only had a single free throw in the second half. That's going to be the second foul now on Andre Nation, who Matt Prady counts on for so many things. He praises his freshman for his great basketball IQ. Kyle Gaylard now at the line with the 17th foul on William and Mary, shooting the front end of a 1-1 and misses. So we saw Devon Moore out of that last JMU timeout score a calming bucket. We'll see what the Dukes have in store here. Davis turning the corner and powers it down.
Excellent refusal that time. It looked like there was going to be a dribble handoff. He faked the handoff. That's a set play. Great call by Matt Brady. And Davis turned the corner. You see right now how talented this young man is. It's a shame, though, that he wasted more than half the season because his head wasn't in the right place.
And William and Mary, off that Duke pressure, turns it over for the sixth time in this first half.
Watch this. He fakes the handoff, turns the corner, and just explodes.
We are seeing between Marcus Thornton and A.J. Davis athleticism supreme. Here's Nation. A three for Andre Nation, and a run for JMU forces Tony Shaver into a timeout as he is see this game down to a one-point contest.
I like it. I like it. Nation and Thornton are going back and forth, but the official needs to relax a little bit. I mean, I saw the entire play. Nation hit a shot, turned around, just smiled at Thornton. Sometimes I think officials get a little overzealous. I mean, there's nothing wrong with, you know, it's a game. You know, that wasn't a dirty play. He wasn't being emotional. Sometimes I think officials just get a little carried away with trying to stop trash talking.
Well, you're enjoying men's action in Richmond, and we invite you to catch all the 2013 CAA Women's Basketball Championship Tournament. It's presented by Janie King, and it takes place next week, March 14th through the 17th, at the Showplace Arena in Upper Marlboro, Maryland. Log on to caasports.com for more details. Let's check in with our third man, Brent Harris.
William and Mary concerned about the turnovers. Six already in this game. They had 20 to 14 in the two meetings earlier this year against James Madison. Now, Tony Shaver said this week, he said there's not much you can do this late in this season when it comes to turnovers. You can't change a whole lot. You just got to go out there and cut down on them. He said that's going to be a key here today. You can't turn the ball over.
To your point, Brent, they are 10th in the conference in turnover margin. They turn the ball over 2.4 times more than they actually have assists. So, and they don't do a very good job on the offensive boards either. So those are the things that worry Tony Shaver. But he sees what his offense can do. But to your point earlier, Ron, you know, sometimes live by the three, die by the three, live by hoisting up shots as soon as you want to. So it's going to be interesting to see how they calm things down here.
Exactly. I like what JMU is doing. Every other possession or so, they're mixing in their full court presses just to try to cut the clock so they don't have to play against this patient, methodical half-court offense that the Tribe are capable of running.
We had a 12-0 William and Mary run answered by that 7-0 JMU run until Russ Tobin in his favorite spot quiets that.
Great call out of the timeout, I think, by Tony Shaver. Last few possessions, the Tribe took a lot of jump shots. He said, you know what, let's go inside, let's go to Russ Tobin, let's give him a touch on the block.
That was a quick release three. That may have been a little too quick for Devon Moore, but if it goes in, Ron.
When Devon pulled up, I'm sitting here shaking my head like, no, no, and he nailed it. As a coach, you say, no, no, great shot, Devon. But that's the shot that I was saying early on. They have to be careful that they don't fall in love with that quick jump shot.
After starting 2 of 10 from the field, they're 9 of their last 11 and 5 of 5 from three. And here they come again. Moore kicks to the corner. That is Charles Cook. Can't get it into the hands of Thornton, who pushes the pace. Rust Hovind again, but we're going to get an offensive foul on on Kyle Gaylord as he passed to Rust Hovind. So frantic action as we come down to 3:38 to go in the first half. Folks, we're tied at 27. Tied at 27 with 3:38 to go in the first half. The last of our three quarterfinal games of the CAA Men's Basketball Tournament. And it's a rematch of what happened last Saturday night in Williamsburg, Virginia, where Marcus Thornton went off. He had 19 first half points, but finished the game with 20. And A.J. Davis for James Madison comes alive, a career high 36 points. And it's the Dukes that beat the Tribe 69-67, as we see the season series. A 19-point deficit JMU rallied from Ron Thompson, and this is despite the fact that William and Mary shot 60% from the field last Saturday. But a whole new ball game tonight, and we are dead even with 3:25 to go.
JMU, they've gone small. You see Diouf, number five, is their tallest ball player on the ball club. He's really like a small forward, and he's playing the five with A.J. Davis, who would be their four man.
And still no Rashawn Goins, as they've gone small. Four to shoot, Curry will, and got it. That was a good look, not a bailout shot, as they ran offensively, and Curry spun to the right spot.
Essentially, JMU, they're playing with four guards and one small forward. A lot of defensive dexterity, a lot of flexibility. They should be able to put a lot of pressure on the ball.
Rust Hovind trying to take advantage of the size matchup against Diouf, but they can't get it into him yet.
See, because of the lineup, they can switch all ball screens and all crosses. As you see, whenever you see a screen for a ball, they're just going to switch.
And a backdoor look, a perfect feed. Matt Rum finds Marcus Thornton.
Oh, that's what happens. You know, Thornton hits a few jump shots, they lull you to sleep, and he cuts back door for the wide open layup.
9 points now for the sophomore, Marcus Thornton. And even though Rum has been quiet in terms of points scored, he's made a few nice entry passes and backdoor look passes for this offense. Davis guns away, back of the iron, and here's Rum. Had it stripped away, Devon Moore comes up with it. The slashing Davis, he'll finish with the finger roll. A.J. Davis again on fire. He's got 12. And a whistle from Sean Cassidy. He's gonna get freshman Curry with the foul.
Take a look at Davis. He catches the ball on the wing. When he gets the ball, he's constantly in attack mode. You don't have to wonder what he's thinking. You don't have to wonder where his mind is. He's trying to get to the basket or get a shot up.
You know, Ron, sitting here at this angle, we see Devon Moore flash right in front of us and throw a high, hard pass. That's a tough catch and finish on in stride the way A.J. Davis made it look easy.
It was, but credit Devon Moore for knowing who he was throwing the ball to. And when you're quarterbacking a ball club, you have to know who your receivers are, and he knew that Davis would catch that ball and finish it. Certain players, Al, you can throw certain passes to, and it's up to the passer to know who his receivers are.
So Britt now with the opportunity to tie this game up. Make that 12 points now for Brandon Britt, who's been on fire in this first half. He is a scorer, averages 13.8 per game, and is a good deep shooter, but not particularly talented at the line, just at 67%, but looked very strong there. As with now under 90 seconds to play first half, we're back to another tie. Davis looking to change that, and will, with an extra shot coming.
He's got it going, Al. He really does, and he's had it going in the last three games or so. He's so strong. Well, you know, he beat his man, but the help came. But he just rose up over him right there. You see, he beats his man on the wing. You see the double team, the help come, but he raises off the dribble and converts it. Scorers can score, and that's what Davis is. He's not a shooter. He's a scorer.
And Ron, from my point of view, it doesn't look like he's been a ball hog. He looks like he's just taking advantage of what has been there and knowing what he can do.
And that has been the difference between the latter part of the season and early on. Early on, he was forcing a lot of shots. He wasn't allowing the offense to work for him. He was pressing the issue. Now he's letting it come to him, and you're seeing his natural offensive ability within the offense.
They feed inside to Rusthoven. He's fouled. And he'll get some shots out of this. So Devon Moore will pick up the foul. That's his second. And the Dukes now with 19 fouls. Rusthoven, though, was fouled in the active shooting, so he will get his two. Rusthoven misses both. Battle for the loose ball, and Diouf comes up with it. As we have now a minute to go in a very entertaining first half of quarterfinal game number 3 from the CAA Men's Basketball Tournament presented by Janie King. A catch and shoot for Curry. There's Thornton high for that board. Terry Tarpey, the freshman wearing number 25 for William & Mary, getting a lot of first half time. Julian Boatner also in the game. Rusthoven surrounded and finds Tarpey.
Great patience by Rusthoven in the double team that time, and Tarpey cut and moved without the ball. What happens, they threw it in the post, and all the JMU defenders out turned and looked at the ball. Tarpey cut back door, and Rusthoven hit him for an easy layup.
Whistle and a turnover gives William & Mary the basketball with 4.5 seconds left.
You see the screen and roll. Diouf sets the screen, but when he rolled, the official thought he took Thornton right with him, and he calls a foul. Great call that time by the official. Diouf was trying to get out of the way, but couldn't really get there fast enough.
So Devon Moore will sit these final 4.5 seconds. Rusthoven trying to beat the buzzer, and that is how the first half ends. It's JMU behind 15 points from A.J. Davis with a one-point lead over Tim Rusthoven and William & Mary, 34-33. Standing by right now with Matt Brady, the head coach at JMU, is our Brent Harris.
All right, thank you very much. Al, one-point lead. What did you like out of your team in the first half?
Well, we got down, but we kept fighting. I thought that we gave up too many easy shots at the rim. We gave up 3 offensive rebounds for baskets. and then we gave up a couple of baskets to Thornton where we weren't ready to guard him. So we've got to do a better job on Thornton. We've got to do a better job on the defensive glass.
A lot of energy out of A.J. Davis. Pretty nice first half. You got to be pleased about that.
Yeah, his shot selection has come a long way here in the last couple months. His defense has gotten better. He gave up a layup there at the end where he didn't identify the weak side. We need A.J. to play at both ends, and we need everybody on our team to rebound a little better.
All right, Coach Brady, best of luck in the second half. Back to you, Al.
Brent, thank you very much. We thank Matt Brady. Brent will try and get a word in with Tony Shaver before the start of the second half on the William & Mary bench. A.J. Davis with 15 points. Marcus Thornton has been hot as well. And William & Mary trailing the Dukes by one. We start our halftime here.
Welcome back to the Richmond Coliseum and the CAA Basketball Tournament. The Colonial Athletic Association would like to acknowledge this year's Dean Ellers Leadership Award recipient, who was honored last night at the Championship Awards Banquet. This award is given in recognition of the longtime James Madison University Athletic Director's contributions to intercollegiate athletics. Welcome back to the Richmond Coliseum and the CAA Basketball Tournament. The Colonial Athletic Association would like to acknowledge this year's Dean Ellers Leadership Award recipient, who was honored last night at the Championship Awards Banquet. This award is given in recognition of the longtime James Madison University Athletic Director's contributions to intercollegiate athletics, which recognizes the men's and women's basketball student athletes who embody the highest standards of leadership, integrity, and sportsmanship in conjunction with their academic and athletic achievements. This year's men's recipient is Jonathan Lee of Northeastern University, a senior from Flint, Michigan, who is majoring in graphic design. The Colonial Athletic Association congratulates Jonathan on this prestigious award. Halftime continues here in Richmond. First half stats and highlights are straight ahead.